Welcome to Ramadan Recipes, where we make savory and sweet dishes for your sehri and for your iftar. And today I'm going to be making Channa Bhaji. This is a staple in Gujarat, especially during the Ramadan period. It's great as a starter and it's quite spicy as well. So let's have a look at the ingredients that we need to make spicy Channa Bhaji. We're going to be taking some onions, some fresh coriander, some curry powder, chili powder, salt, turmeric, fresh green chilies, and some chickpeas, and a little bit of oil for shallow frying. So for the Channa Bhaji, I'm going to take a frying pan and then add some oil to this. And this is on a medium heat. Make sure you swirl the oil round. And then we're going to add in the onions. So what we're going to do is make sure the onions become brown and softer. So it might take a few minutes, probably about 4 minutes for that to happen. And we're spreading them around the pan so that they become softer and much more golden in colour more quickly. And if you raise the heat slightly a bit more, it can happen much quicker. So I'm going to let that brown for at least 4 minutes. So now the onions are completely brown, they become slightly crispy as well. So this is a perfect time to add in the chickpeas. So I'm going to add that in and give that a stir so it's coated with the onion and the oil mixture. And this is on a medium heat. I'm also now going to add the spices as well. Scatter that in. Give that a mix. Make sure you coat the spices around the edge of the chickpeas and don't let any of them go uncovered. So you want to make sure all the flavours seep through. And this is the time when you add in the chilies as well. If you don't like too much chilies, then it's perfectly fine to leave them out. But I like to add a little bit of zing to that. And I quite like a lot of green chili actually. This is really great, especially for a starter, at the start of Ramadan iftar. So it's brilliant as something that you can eat before your main meal. And again, we're gonna leave this on a high heat and cook for around 2 minutes to let everything seep through and the flavors come through to the chickpeas. So now we've allowed the spices to go into the chickpeas and become really well mixed with the onions. I'm going to add in some fresh coriander to this and then give that a stir and it's almost ready to serve. You can also add in a bit of lemon juice if you wanted to, or some lime juice. That adds a bit more zing to it, but I think it's perfectly fine as it is. So now it's ready to serve and you can eat that on its own or alongside some other dishes such as meat dishes. Channa Bhaji is actually really high in nutritional value. This is packed with protein, perfect for keeping you full for longer and energized as well during the next fasting day. It also contains a high level of soluble fiber, and that's something that can keep your appetite under control and also keep your blood sugar levels under control as well. So if you have diabetes, this is great for managing that. This actually contains a high level of quercetin, because that is all contained in the onions, and that really controls allergies. So it really helps with the allergy control and also boosts your immune system. Now here's a reminder of a recap of the instructions and how to prepare spicy Channa Bhaji. To a frying pan, add some oil and then add the onions and fry with the salt until the onions have become soft and golden. Then add the chili powder and the spices and keep stirring. Now add the chickpeas and fry on a high heat for 2 minutes while stirring. Lower the heat and add the green chilies and the fresh coriander, stir that in and let it simmer for 4 minutes and then serve hot. So I hope you've enjoyed making the Channa Bhaji with me today. It's something that you can enjoy as an appetizer or a side dish with your iftar. Make sure you make it for your iftar today, and also have it throughout Ramadan as well. Happy Ramadan to you.